Stunning follow-up now to a security story we first told you about yesterday out of San Diego. An assistant port director telling a reporter that a weapon of mass destruction was found on U.S. soil. He was then quickly interrupted by the public affairs officer who's there to sort of monitor contact with the media. The comment and the intervention raising some serious questions. And now we've gotten a look at the entire interview. Trace Gallagher, live in our West Coast newsroom with more. Trace.
As soon as we did this story yesterday, Megan, every state and federal security agency began working overtime trying to knock this thing down, saying that assistant port director was misspoken or that he was nervous or that he was flat out wrong. So we went back, we looked at the entire interview to see if he had somehow been taken out of context. The interview lasted several minutes. He was not taken out of context. We checked to see if there was any kind of creative editing. Was it cut short? It was not. So I want to play you this soundbite again and listen to what he says, watch his eyes, and then listen when the PIO starts to jump in. Watch.
Specifically, you're looking for the dirty bomb. You're looking for a nuclear device.
Correct. Weapons of mass effect.
You ever found one?
Not at this location.
But they have found them.
Yes, well.
I know that you're
off camera, the public affairs officer interrupted. You never found one in San Diego, though?
I would say at the Port of San Diego, we have not.
Have you found one in San Diego?
I'm trying to.
Again, we'll just talk about the Port of San Diego. I'll follow up later.
So again, the PIO says she's going to follow up. It took her 23 days. Who is this guy? His name is Al Haller. He is the assistant port director, right? He is also a Customs and Border Protection officer. We did some checking. He's in his mid-40s. His pay scale says our brain room is about GS-13, about $90,000 a year, which is a very high position within this administration. He has access, therefore, to a great deal of information. We could not find, though, any record of him doing any prior interviews. And Customs and Border Protection issued this statement after the story ran yesterday, and I'm quoting, during a local interview on port security that aired last week, a U.S. Customs and Border Protection assistant port director in San Diego made statements that were simply inaccurate. CPB has not encountered any weapons of mass effect at or between ports of entry anywhere in the United States. Very adamant in their denial. He said there were weapons of mass effect, not in San Diego, but somewhere, didn't specify, and now they're saying absolutely not. Megan.
So Al had not done any interviews prior to this one, and you could bet he won't be doing any now.
Yeah, he won't be doing any more. That,
you know,
we could find, we should say.
It was, he says it's so. Now you've got the official saying, you know, he's wrong. He's, quote, simply inaccurate. And we'll let our viewers be the judge of who they believe on that. Did he look confused? Do you think he was wrong? We're taking your emails on it. Kelly at foxnews.com. Trace, thanks. Good reporting.